right?
Love you pointing it to me. I think, yeah, it's set in the 1970s, that's for sure. But it's, let's say it's inspired by a lot of things. I don't want to get into details as to what it's inspired by, because I think Milan's a better person to ask.
Yeah, inspired by an incident which we really don't know that it's true or no. But we've heard of an incident and we played the film around that. Though it has got nothing to do with the incident. It's technically a story of these characters, basically all of us, six bad asses, but basically the problem is hers
yeah,
in the film.
The problem is mine in the film, where he's going to set out to help me out. So there's not much that I want to reveal about the film, because it'll be better if you actually see it for yourself. But it is primarily...
It's got that, you know, a little bit of suspense in the film, what happens when. So it's difficult to speak about the film much.
Exactly.
He is kind of a bodyguard, but that's the part, that's a part of the film. That's just a prologue of the film. In fact, the story goes somewhere else completely.
Yeah.
She was feeling that too much. She kept to herself. She was wearing that costume and sitting in her room alone, not talking to anybody. She was thinking she was a princess.
Rubbish.
What happened?
What do you mean it happened? As in like off screen?
They asked you the question.
I think, you know, when you're playing characters like this, especially something that's set in the 1970s that you're not really too familiar with, it's a lot easier to feel part of the character when you're in your costume. And I think that definitely helped me. I had no idea whether I'd be able to pull it off, you know, playing a royal, playing someone who is, of course, a royal in the 70s, that too. You know, there's a certain kind of way you walk, a certain way you talk, and she's a very complicated character. So she's not, she's very layered. So there's a lot that you don't see about it. There's a lot that's going on when she's talking. And I think that was something that was quite tricky to pull off, but I had a great co-star with me. Yeah, I kind of irritated him quite a few times.
She doesn't have a choice. She has to say that I'm sitting next to her.
No, but genuinely, I'm actually giving you a compliment.
Thank you. For every film, they ask me this question and I say it is nonsense when people say we really prepared for the movie.
We
you just feel it, you go out and do it. That's what I believe in. I don't know how people prepare for a role. I really don't understand that. For me, it's instinctive. What I feel at that point of time, I don't even know before the shot what I'm going to do in the shot. But I definitely do, when I'm standing in front of the camera, I definitely feel that I'm that character and what that character would do at that point of time. The song we have in the film, Rashke Kamar, I think it's one of my favorite songs ever. I love that song a lot. And when we shot the song, we weren't sure if this was the song. So we shot it on some other song actually.
Yeah.
Then we got the song and we put the song on and I love it.
Absolutely. I mean, if I can add to that, I've actually even tweeted, because I was so obsessed with it. I even said, like, is it vain that I'm obsessed with my own song for my own film? But I actually am. I think it's amazing for me. And I think I heard it, honestly, for the first time, almost along with everyone else. The day before it came out was when I actually heard it.
And I'm happy that we're not wrong, because it's the number one song.
It is. And I'm so happy and I'm so proud of our team. I think it's an outstanding song. The lyrics are so beautiful. It really works for the characters. It works for that part of the film. And I think it's amazing. I can't pick a certain part. I mean, I suppose once you see the movie, you'll understand what I mean, because there's not this one particular scene that I loved the most, or there's not one particular section of this film that I enjoyed shooting the most. There were so many parts to it. The best part was the fact that Milan actually saw this character in me. Now, I don't know how he assumed that I'd be able to pull it off, but I was just so excited to play something so different, so unusual, and just, again, so layered. I think it really excites me when I'm playing something that can't even be written as clearly on paper. There's so much going on with this person, and there's so many things that you have to say without even saying anything. And that's what I loved about this role. I love the fact that she's layered, she's complicated, she's not necessarily a good person. Everyone has their bits of grey in them, and she's also one of them, so she's quite a badass, and I love that.
As an actor, when you play a character, you don't think which part you're going to enjoy and which part you're going to not enjoy, because I think that's not right and that's not fair. So when you become a character, you cannot be that, oh, today is, you know, today's a comic scene, so I'm going to enjoy this. If today is an action scene, I'm not going to enjoy this. When you become a character, you just play it. So it's not that you enjoy a particular kind of genre in the in your character. Yeah, the best part what I enjoyed while doing the film was not during the shots, between the shots actually, because we had great co-stars of the team, so we had a lot of fun. I wouldn't enjoy sitting 2 hours for makeup, waking up at 4 in the morning. That I wouldn't enjoy. I wouldn't enjoy the kind of costumes women have to wear and she had to wear in the film. Yeah, I would enjoy the fact that, you know, when you're a woman and you're a girl and you're on the sets, you really get pampered, and we don't get pampered here that way. By the
way, who's pampered?
Everybody pampers.
Nobody pampers me.
What rubbish?
Rubbish. You didn't pamper me, so who pampered me? No one pampered me.
Everybody pampered you.
No.
We were all nice to you.
You were nice to me, so I was nice to you too.
So that's
pampering. Doesn't mean I'm pampering
you. That's pampering.
I was pampering you, that means.
You were not nice to me.
I'd honestly enjoy the baritone very much. I've been dubbing off late and I was just like, I'm so envious of the deep husky voice. Kind of, it can be nice to have a very deep husky voice. Not for a woman though.
Not
a little scary for a woman. He's definitely a prankster. But he
what
didn't.
What prank did I
not play? On me, that's what I was getting to that. We had a deal, he didn't play pranks on me. He's very nice to me, he didn't play pranks.
See, and you
on
said
me.
I didn't pamper you.
You were nice to me, I'm not saying you pampered me.
I didn't play any prank on you.
No.
So I pampered you.
No, because I asked you not to.
So I pampered you.
No! You were nice to me. I think at the most, this is the kind of film that's very unusual. It's not your typical Bollywood film. It's got the elements of action and drama and romance and all of that. But it's a very unusual film. It's a very different film. We can't explain too much about the film here, so I think you should definitely go out and see it if you want to see two incredibly cool badasses. You have to go see it. Go see it for him as well. If you don't want to see it for me, go see it for him. You have to say anything?